Alright guys, so before I actually build the farm, I'm going to make a temporary platform out here so that if I die, I don't lose all of my stuff in the void, because yeah, it's quite possible that I could fall off, and the thing is going to end up being tall enough so that if you fall off, you will die, even with protection 4, feather falling 4, and yeah. I think 2 protection 4s gives you the maximum possible protection that you're able to get. So, yeah. And you noticed that again as we came out here, there was an Enderman out on here. I only had 2 spawnable blocks here, but the Enderman still managed to spawn. So let's see. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 10. So, the way an Enderman farm works is that, yeah, I don't like this situation at all. So yeah, as I was saying before being rudely interrupted, is that the way an Enderman farm works is that, if you'll let me finish my sentence, thank you. So anyway, as I was going to say, the reason an Enderman farm is so good is because, well, with any mob system, what you want to do is make it so that the only place where mobs can spawn is inside your mob system. And, when we made the witch farm, we had to get the thing to work, we had to light up as much of the area around the farm as possible. We had to light up basically every cave, and you're never going to do a perfect job, but you need to do as good a job as you can, and that prevents mobs from spawning outside your farm, so that, okay, good, I think I only looked at the one that had already fallen down into the void, so. Jesus, Lord, mercy. Guys are noisy. So yeah, we have to light it up because the game will only spawn mobs if there's less than like 80 hostile mobs spawn, and if there's more than that, then it won't spawn any. So usually, so if you want the game to spawn mobs in your mob farm, you have to make sure that you're not using up the mob cap by having mobs spawned outside the farm. Now with an Enderman farm, you're actually able to, the Mojang has literally given you, as a prize for beating the boss of the game, the Ender Dragon, the prize is literally a vacuum. So you get to build a mob farm in a vacuum with nothing else around it. And that means that the only blocks that Enderman can spawn on are blocks that you place. So that means that you're going to get spawning at maximum efficiency. And it turns out that if you're not waiting for other hostile mobs to despawn, the rate at which the game will spawn mobs on any given block is actually really high. I mean, you notice that each time we came out to the end when we just had those 2 spawnable blocks at the end of the tunnel before I started making this platform, every single time we came out, there was an Enderman spawned on there. Every single time. And that's just one block out of thousands, even, you know, probably even millions that it could spawn an Enderman on around us, and it spawned it there. So the game spawns mobs really quickly when you will spawn mobs really quickly if it's not working against the mob cap, and we're going to use that to our advantage in this Enderman farm of ours. Okay guys, so I went and completed this platform and I put torches on it because if you do not, then Enderman will spawn like crazy out here. So now, what I'm going to do is simply create a landing platform in the middle of this temporary platform. It's going to be 6 meters by 20 meters centered on these 4 blocks here. So, with that in mind, let's come out like this and then 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yeah. Excellent. And yeah, we'll just make this platform. What do I want to make it out of? You're fucking kidding me. You guys spawned on here? Damn it. Okay. Well, whatever. So anyway, I've made up my mind. The landing platform will be made out of snow, just like the floor to my... Well, not the floor, but the... just like the little platform out there before you get into the ice tunnel. So yeah, the landing platform will be made out of snow. And yeah. And then for the in the central part of it, where the Enderman actually will land, this two-block wide part, it'll be made out of something different. Perhaps iron or perhaps stone brick. I do not know. So yeah, we'll just simply fill this in. Ah, yes, had another indecisive moment out there, but I've made a decision. The central part will be made of stone brick, because I want the Enderman to fall on cold, hard concrete, because falling on concrete's especially hard on your knees. It'll make their legs snap extra badly. I don't want them to fall on something soft like snow. And iron, well, metals are malleable and ductile, so it'll have a little bit more give than cold, hard concrete. I really hate Endermen. Of the two sort of neutral, hostile mobs, Endermen are my least favorite by far. I mean, zombie pigmen are cool, you know? I like them. They stick up for their buddies. Now, if you stick up for your friends, then I respect you. But Endermen, they get pissed off if you look at them. Like, Jesus, dude, what the heck? Alright, so I added this glowstone here just so that the platform will be lit up. And now, what Panda has us do, and yes, I am following his tutorial pretty much to the letter. Well, not quite to the letter. I mean, I'm using iron bars here instead of wood fences. I hope that doesn't make a difference. I mean, it could potentially make a difference if the Enderman farm were to take advantage of the hitbox of the wood fence, but I know how it works, so I don't think that it will make any difference. So yeah, we're just going to stack around here, make a nice little cage with the iron bars here. I'm doing the iron bars because I love iron. You probably figured that out when I built an iron golem farm right at the start of my Let's Play before even farming any cows or anything like that. So we make these... so now we have kind of a cage around here, and of course we've got to make a place to enter. What do I want to do for the door? What to do? Yeah, we'll do a doorway like this. And we'll have some doors or some sort of cool entrance or something there. I don't know. It'll be neat, whatever it is, though. Okay, so now what we're gonna do is make a little roof here. And I'm gonna leave a link to in the description to Panda4994's tutorial on the Enderman farm, because this it really is it's something that every good Minecrafter should know. This isn't just an experience farm, this is the experience farm. Okay, if you want to make an experience farm that lets you enchant stuff really quickly, this is the way to go. There is no better design than Panda's. This is such a good design both for its effectiveness and for its simplicity. Unlike some other farms out there that are, you know, really tedious and time consuming to build. You know, building one of these Enderman farms doesn't take all that long. I mean, it's a bit heavy on the pistons, but it doesn't use like that many. Like, if you spend a reasonable amount of time mining, you know, strip mining, you'll easily get enough resources to build an Enderman farm. And you don't even have to build some sort of mob system to get the spiders, because if you explore a lot of abandoned mine shafts, you can get enough tripwire that way. So, you know, it's pretty cheap, considering what it does, that is. And it's just incredibly effective. You can't get better than this Enderman farm design. And credit goes to Panda4994. DocM77, I believe, is the one who came up with the Enderman farm design, the one that used to be best before Tripwire was introduced. So he's the first, I think he's the first person who built a really good Enderman farm in the end like this. And he made it before they created Tripwire. So both of them get tons of credit, get credit for this. Check out both their channels. Really good. They're what we'd call Minecraft pros, pro players, if there was a professional Minecraft scene, and there should be. There should be. All right, so now we need to jump stack up 40 blocks here. So I've just put 40 blocks in the hotbar so that I don't lose count, because you really want to be accurate on this. If you were, for example, to not go up enough, then the Enderman wouldn't be a one-hit KO, and that'd be a really big mistake to make, because then your entire farm would be at the wrong height. And it's not like you can lower the platform, because, yeah, platform's at the slow as it can go. So really want to make sure you're accurate on this one. So yeah, we're just going to jump stack up to 40 blocks. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And yeah, we'll put some ladders on. I think with all these enchantments, I could survive a fall down 40 blocks, but yeah. Better to be a little safe than sorry. And huh, it's already working. Except not really, because that's not going to be where the Endermen spawn. Alright, so we are up 40 blocks now. We'll just put these here so that I know that it is at the top. And we'll do that so that we don't have some of those guys spawning. There we go. Hey, you. Guess what this is? That's right, I'm going to farm your people. Okay. Yeah, go away. Oh, nice. Got an Ender Pearl. Alright, so now what we're going to do is we're going to place rings of blocks with a 2 or 2.5 block gap between them. It's 2.5 blocks here because of the half slabs, but I'm just going to use full blocks because honestly, doing this with half slabs and placing a block on the tiny little face of a half slab is kind of tedious. And also, once way back in the day, there was this terrible lighting glitch with half slabs, and I built an Enderman farm and used half slabs as Panda recommended, and yeah, it looked like parts of it were broken, so. Since then, I've always had kind of an aversion to building Enderman farms out of half slabs. God damn it. Okay, yeah, and we're also going to be adding a little thing here like that so that we can stand. We don't have to worry about Enderman spawning here because the gap is only 2 blocks wide. Ow. Aren't you glad we built a platform? Yeah. And yeah, we're just going to do this all the way to the top. These will keep the Enderman from escaping. And yeah. I suppose I could be counting as I was going and as I'm going, and then I wouldn't risk falling off the end because I'd know when I'm about to reach the end. Although, actually, I'm already there. Get it? Yeah, that was bad. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Always wanted to build an Enderman farm out of solid iron blocks. I don't know why I've always had that obsession, why an Enderman farm specifically, but something, I wanted to build something big and impressive and, you know, with great utility out of iron blocks. Ouch.
So much fun working together, they get the job done. Bob the Builder, can we fix it? Bob the Builder, yes we can. Bill Chit and Bird, Travis and Spud, playing together like good friends should. Bob the Builder, can we fix it?
Alright, so before I begin on the next part, I'm just going to run back and grab as many iron blocks as I can fit in my inventory, because I don't have to get interrupted or anything. Let's see. Yeah, we got some in here. We'll get rid of the snow for now, because we don't really need it. And yeah, there we go. We don't need that much wood on us. Okay, perfect. And normally I'd do that off camera, but I figured that since we get to run through this awesome autobahn, we'd do it together, because this is just so awesome. I mean, look how fast everything's flying by. Yeah. I did, however, cut out me climbing up this horrible slow ladder that's really long and annoying, but it's not quite worth it to build a minecart elevator, because after I build the farm, I'm not going to be climbing up it ever again. Okay, so we are back. Now it's time to do the next part. I was just double-checking the tutorial, and of course I forgot to put torches up here. Also, you notice a bunch of Endermen are collected down here. These guys have just been walking right off the edge, and... yeah, I haven't even put in any of the pistons yet. Heck, I don't even have one of the spawning floors. This isn't going to be one of the spawning floors here. And the farm is already working. All right, so I went and made some buttons here. We need 32 for the 16-wide version of Panda's farm that I'm making. In Panda's tutorial, he made it 13-wide. I don't know whether there's any significance to that number or whether he just chose to make it like that. I'm doing 16-wide just because 16's a nice even number, and then that way you need exactly half a stack of pistons for each level, and I kind of like that. In other videos that I've seen of other servers, like for example, the Hermitcraft, some videos I've seen of the Hermitcraft server, I believe their Enderman farm is also 13 wide, so there may be some special reason why 13 is a magic number. I don't know, or maybe it was built on Friday the 13th. Yeah, I don't know why it is. Or maybe it reaches some critical rate and you don't really get any gains by making it larger than 13 wide. I don't know. But whatever, I'm just going to do 16 wide for mine, because, yeah. And now we need some vines. And, yeah, we'll just put them all around the edge. Need to be too long, but we can just put them on top here, and then they will grow. Yeah. Oh, and off camera, I tested to see if I could survive falling off falling the 43 blocks. I think I only fell 40. I survived with 2 hearts left, but keep in mind there is some randomness to protection enchantments, so you might survive with more health, or you might die sometimes. So it's not recommended that you jump in here. I don't know whether you'd survive, but sometimes you'll survive falling down in Enderman Farm if you're wearing maximum enchantments on your armor. And I'm just putting the rest of the vines here because I don't want to have them in my inventory, because I don't need them anymore. And if I throw them away, then I'll just end up picking them up later. So, yeah, that's that. Okay, so now it's time to actually start doing all the fun redstone stuff. And yet another beautiful thing about this design is that it doesn't even require any really complicated redstone or anything. So, yeah, we'll just need some pistons, some redstone, and yeah. I'll move this out of the hotbar because I definitely don't need a bow in the end after you've beaten the Ender Dragon. So yeah. Oh, I need the tripwire hooks. I forgot those. Oh wait, no, I didn't. They're right here. Okay, so basically, now we have to come over here and we stack up three blocks, and we put a tripwire hook right here. I'll link Panda's tutorial because it's much more to the point than this will be. Now we can just place the tripwire like this. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. And let's see, need some temporary blocks now. Oh, we'll use the stone brick, because... And then we... this is the block that we'll place the redstone on. And then we can just do that, like this. And these blocks, this row of blocks... Oops! Gotta replace that tripwire here. And this is the row of blocks that's going to power the pistons that will end up pushing the Enderman off the farm, so, yeah. And then we just do that, and there we go. Now this trip line is set, and let's just hop up here, and we'll go ahead and place the redstone on top, like this. Get rid of that temporary block. And now we get to place the pistons on top, and we're going to be careful not to jump up, or we'll trigger the trip lines and get pushed off, just like an Enderman. Yet another excellent thing about this design, compared to the older pressure plate Enderman farms, is that it's not even hard to build. Like, we can stand in here without risking triggering the Enderman, without triggering it, you know? So, that's definitely a plus. Now, we simply do the exact same thing on the other side. And I'll either speed this up or do it off camera. Alright, so this layer is almost done, but there's just one little thing we gotta do. We have to, build the next layer, we have to put half slabs, basically, to make sure that Endermen can't spawn in here, because they'd be able to spawn right there. And a half slab on top of this first block with the redstone that's right next to the tripwire hook, and then a half slab on the tripwire hook. And for these half slabs, don't place them right on those blocks, because then they obstruct air blocks that are just above the spawning pad. Like, for example, don't place the half slabs like this, because they obstruct air blocks that that the game might choose to try and spawn a pack of Endermen on the spawning pad, and we don't want to do that. so do play some like this, even though it might seem just might seem at first glance to be a little bit easier to do to just play some down here, and then you can. I don't know if it might seem easier, but just don't do it, okay? It won't hurt the efficiency too badly, but you know, no reason to hurt the efficiency of the farm at all when there's a simple thing you can do that will not hurt the efficiency of the farm. All right, so that layer is complete. Oh, and of course we don't have to put a half slab on this one because this is going to be our ladder or column. Where the ladders are on. Okay, so now we can actually just build the next spawning platform. And yeah, we can place these blocks right on top of the tripwire here like this. So you'll notice there's a 3-block gap between this row of blocks and the spawning floor below it. Which is enough for Enderman to fit in. So yeah, we'll just do this. Oops! I messed up. I triggered it.
So much fun working together, they get the job done. Built to the bird, Travis and Spud playing together like good friends should.
Okay, guys, we are on the last level. I figured that since this is the last level of the Enderman farm, I thought it might be cool if we did it together. So, yeah, let me tell you, I think it only takes like 2 or 3 hours for me to build this, but it sure seems a lot longer. And it's, I don't know, I think one of the main things about it is that so much of building the farm is doing tedious things like sneaking, placing temporary blocks, you know, walking very carefully so that you don't step off the edge and activate the farm and stuff like this, making sure not to jump after you place the tripwire, running back and forth, placing more temporary blocks. You know what I'm talking about. It's not one of those, you know, place a whole bunch of blocks really quickly type of builds. Let me tell you, I did fall a few times while building this. Unfortunately, the camera wasn't rolling, or Fraps, rather, wasn't rolling when I did fall, but it's scary. Most of the time, I was able to catch myself on the vines. For some reason, the Endermen aren't quite smart enough to do that. Of course, if they were really smart, what they'd do is they'd all teleport up here right now and kick my ass so that I couldn't finish building this. I mean, I'm sure if they all, like, let's say they were being controlled by human players, they could make it so it'd be impossible for me to build this farm right now if they just teleported right up here. We'll assume for the sake of this example that they teleport by throwing ender pearls the same way that players do. Oh wait, did I put the redstone on top yet? No, I didn't. But yeah, I've often thought that'd be a cool idea, is to have like a... it could be a modded version of Minecraft, but it'd be a server mod where you set up a server so that humans can play as mobs that spawn. So if you want to... servers that are using this mod, let's say that you wanted to play as a mob, you'd simply select the mob that you want to play as, and then your client would look for it would search for a server that's trying to spawn a certain mob of that type. So let's say that a server tries to, you know, does the mob spawn thing and says, okay, I'm going to spawn a creeper. The client would then look and see if there are any players that are waiting to play as a creeper, and if there are, it would then connect to that player and give that player control of the mob. It'd be kind of like queuing up for a match in say StarCraft or League of Legends or something. So yeah. Oh, derp, I forgot, to put the tripwire in here. I don't know, I've just always thought that'd be kind of a cool idea. Of course, it could be disastrous. Like, I mean, imagine what griefers could do. It could be really bad. Like, and there are also some questions that have to be answered. For example, the fact that creepers only explode when they're near players, is that just the way the creeper AI is set up, or would we make it so that its creepers are only capable of exploding when they're close to a player? I think you'd have to go with the second one. Otherwise, griefers could just, continually spawn as a creeper and blow up everyone's shit, and that wouldn't be cool. So let's see. Yeah, so since this is the top layer, I think that I'll just put half slabs over everything. And we don't want to... We're at Y equals 125 right now, and obviously if we were to get more than 128 blocks above the ground, that'd be pointless because mobs can't spawn when you're more than 128 blocks away from a player, so... Yeah, I think we'll just... Oops, made that a full block by accident. Don't want to do that. But yeah. And also, are Enderman able... Would an Enderman that's being controlled by a player, would it be able to attack any player that it chooses to? Or would it be physically impossible for it to attack a player that hasn't looked at it? Those are the types of questions that we'd have to answer. But I don't know, that could be a cool mod for Minecraft. Maybe once I go back to college, get a degree in programming, that'll be a project of mine to make the human controlled mobs mod for Minecraft. As if mobs aren't scary enough as is. Okay, I think this is it. Now I have to jump back down to the ladder. And I'll just go ahead and put the ladders all the way up to the top, even though we don't really need them anymore since we're going to be climbing down now. Figure may as well, just because I'm anal retentive and whatnot. So that could be a... But yeah, you know, with some proper, you know, restrictions and nerfs, it could be quite fun. Although it could be kind of boring playing as a mob. I mean, you can't run very fast. You can't destroy blocks. Imagine if you constantly... And man, imagine how frustrating it'd be if you kept spawning in, like, an Enderman farm and you were kind of stuck and couldn't do anything. It's like, damn, this is the 8 million... I wish these players would stop experience grinding. This is the 8 millionth time I've spawned in an experience grinder. Oh boy. Alright, so we're going to test this thing out now. And so you guys can get an idea of how fast this thing really is, I'm going to briefly put the game to peaceful to despawn all these Endermen, and then I will change it to hard. Oh, here they come. They're literally spawning faster than I can kill them here. Oh, hello. You mad, bro? You mad? Oh, he's mad. He's mad, buddy. He's mad. Okay, guys, so I've gone ahead and I've made a little enchantment area. Now, for this farm to technically be done, What we have to do is remove this this ugly temporary platform that we created, and create a water curtain all around the outside of the farm so that Enderman can't teleport out. However, it's quite late at night, and I have to work at 9 a.m. tomorrow. And after building 20 levels on this farm, which is more than I've ever built on any Enderman farm in any other world I've done, I just want to play with the new Enderman farm. So I figured let's do some enchanted books. Let's just enchant a whole bunch of books. That's my plan for this farm, is to mostly do enchanted books, and then I'll bring the books back to the overworld and put them on tools. The issue, as I said, is that you can't, wow, I can't even see a damn thing. Is that, it's gonna be quite tedious to bring a bunch of tools with us, to enchant each time we want to come. This is my, tool enchantments, this is my sword enchantments, and then here will be armor enchantments. And I did a couple earlier, and I even got one book that has multiple enchantments. But man, look how quickly we got to level 30. I love this thing. They're literally spawning faster than I can hit them. We need to come up with a better way of killing them that will still give the player experience. Because right now, that's the limiting variable. The limiting variable isn't that it's not spawning him fast enough, it's that I can't kill him fast enough to free up the mob cap. Yeah, having all 20 layers definitely makes a difference. Oh yeah, and we're gonna need some sort of food farm out here, because I'm gonna go get hungry so quickly. Looting 3, nice, that's a great book to have, so yeah. Alright, let's see what we get here. Lure! What the hell is lure? What the hell is lure? Lure. I've never heard of that. Oh my god. It's been too long since I've played, guys. I have literally not heard of that enchantment before. Is it like a... That goes on a fishing rod, doesn't it? Lure goes on a fishing rod. Yeah, I think that's it. Oh yeah, and my axe broke while I was out here working, so... I made an iron one, and of course enchanted it, because why the hell not? Alright guys, well, I think I'm going to end the episode here. It's 2:16 a.m. right now, and I have to work at 9, and I have to get up early because I have to mail in my taxes and crap. So, yeah. Before I head out, let me just show you what we've got. First, we've got to spend these levels. Oh, Unbreaking 3. And I'm always happy to have as many Unbreaking books as possible because it's a really useful enchantment. There are many things that can get that enchantment from a book, but they can't get it otherwise. So let me show you some of the better things I've gotten. I was able to combine stuff to get this Efficiency 5 book here. Which is always nice. I always like to have that. I got a whole bunch of Unbreaking books, which is great. And I also got Fortune and Silk Touch, so that's cool and all. For swords, let's see. I was able to get Fire Aspect. I can come down here. I was able to combine get two Smite 5 books. Looting 3 is always nice to have. This will be a great enchantment as soon as they make a big scary arthropod boss. And I was able to get Sharpness 5, which is a great enchantment to have. I might end up putting that on an axe, because, you know, it really saves space in your hotbar when you can just have your axe instead of your sword. I was able to get 3 Protection 4s for armor, which is awesome. It's my favorite protection enchantment, what I use most of the time. Yeah, standard stuff for bows. And then in this chest, I got some weird combinations of stuff, including this Power 5 book. I'll definitely be putting that on a bow. So yeah, overall, got a good haul.